He still high and lifted up. He still sits on the throne. He is the I am that I am. He's everything that we need. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. If you're under the sound of my voice, amen. Praise ye the Lord, amen. Whether you're joining us today by airways, YouTube, in the parking lot, amen. Praise ye the Lord. Don't miss this opportunity to praise God, amen. If you're on this side, praise the Lord, amen. He alone is worthy. God alone is worthy, amen. If you got breath in your lungs, praise the Lord, amen. If you have the activities of your limbs, you got something to praise the Lord about, amen. And if you know him, amen, you surely should give him a praise, amen. Amen, because he is a good God. He's an awesome God. He's a worthy God. He's a loving God. He is a merciful God. God is a merciful God. He's a good God, amen. And we praise him today, amen. We come to you from New Liberty Tabernacle of Praise, 924 East Broad Street, here in Gadsden, Alabama, amen. And we come again to lift and praise the name of Jesus. Despite what's going on, amen, God is worthy to be praised. He's still in control, amen. He will stay in control. God is worthy to be praised, amen. Praise ye the Lord, amen. Praise the Lord, amen. Now I want to say to those of you, amen, that have suffered loss this week and in the days past, amen, our prayers are with you. Our heartfelt prayers are with you. And we want to lift up some names today, amen, that of those that have gone on. And let's be praying for these families in the days ahead. Amen. That God will give you comfort and give you peace. Amen. And keep loving God because he keeps loving us. God is a good God. Amen. So the names are, we're going to lift up the Oliver family, Miss Julie Oliver, Miss Phyllis Russell, Miss Cassandra English. Amen. And I was told a young man of the neighborhood passed yesterday. His first name is Richard. I don't know his last name, amen. But if you know him, pray for his family. Miss Dorothy Green and Miss Dorothy Carter. Amen. And I know I didn't call all the names, but we pray for those that have lost their loved ones, that God would comfort you, give you peace, and meet your needs in Jesus' name. Amen. And we want to say happy birthday to some very special people. Amaria. Right here. Jackie Jennings' birthday is today. Jackie and Jermaine's birthday is today. And our own very special sister, Valerie Borden, will be celebrating a birthday tomorrow. Brother Joseph Johnson on the 18th. Sister Blanca Bishop. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sister Regina Johnson on the 20th. Sister Lucretia Love on the 20th. Sister Patrice Maxwell on the 21st. Praise the Lord. Amen. Brother Deacon Rudolph Williams also on the 21st. And Sister Tamara McGay on the 23rd. Happy birthday to you, you, and you. And if I didn't call your name and you're celebrating the birthday this week, happy birthday to you also. We don't have any anniversaries. And I want to read a passage of scripture to you before we bring our pastor forward. Thank you. I'll be reading from Matthew chapter 6, verse 31 through 33. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? What shall we drink? Or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. The world is pulling on our attention right now to get our attention focused towards so many other things that's going on. But we got to stay focused. Don't be distracted. And keep God first at all times. Seek God. Amen. This is the time, the first part of this year, and it should be every day. Amen. That we turn special attention towards God. Seek him first, and all things shall be added unto you. Do not be distracted. This is not a time for getting distracted. Keep your eyes and keep your focus on Jesus. Amen. And at this time, amen. Praise the Lord. Give God some praise as we get ready to receive our pastor. Pastor of this house, Pastor Willie James Simmons.
Because he's worthy. Somebody lift him up. Because he's worthy. Exalt his name because he's worthy. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy to be exalted. He's worthy to be magnified. Praise God. Hallelujah. Feel the atmosphere. Break up the atmosphere with praise. The word of God says praise steals the enemy. Oh, you ought to let praise come out of your mouth. Hallelujah. Somebody say Jesus. The most powerful name that is the name that is above every name. Jesus. Yeshua. Somebody say hallelujah. HaMashiach, the anointed one. Somebody say glory to God. Hallelujah. Mighty God, the one that stands in the midst of the seven candlesticks, praise God, controlling the churches. Somebody said, praise his name. The one that holds the seven stars in his hands. He's with the shepherds. He's with the messengers, praise God. Planted in your church. And somebody said, glory. Hallelujah. 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 Consecrate this ground. Hallow. This is holy ground, praise God. His praise steals the enemy. What the enemy plans to do has to be stopped right now. If you will just praise him in your home right now, praise God, the enemy will have to stop. He'll have to flee. Hallelujah. Somebody say glory. What's his name? I'm talking about the Lamb out of the tribe of Judah. He was a lamb, but now he's a lamb. He's a lion. He was a lamb, that now he is a lion. Tribe of Judah. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, magnify his name with me. Give him glory. Somebody say Jesus. Woo, what a marvelous, marvelous, mighty weapon the name of Jesus is. Hallelujah. Praise. I feel the atmosphere is shifting. I don't care what you see, but it is shifting. There's a change that's going on. It's illuminating darkness so that you can see the light. The pants of America is being pulled down so you can see exactly how she is. But don't fear that, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When your cup of iniquity fills up, the cup of light begins to flow over also. Somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a mighty name. Our Savior, praise God. Hallelujah. Bless his name. As you look, praise God, I want you to pray with me. Father, we thank you for your love and your kindness and your blessing. We thank you for our opportunity today. What a beautiful day. A day to be outside. A day, Lord, to release your word. To release your word into the atmosphere. To break up, Lord, the atmosphere of fear. The atmosphere of anxiety. The atmosphere, God, of worry and doubt. And unbelief, praise God. We break it up right now in the name of Jesus. And we release faith. We release faith in Jesus, praise God. All over this place, angels are ascending and descending, praise God. Ministering in this place, up and down East Broad, up and down, praise God, Meegan, up and down Hope Street, praise God, North Gaston, East Gaston, West Gaston, South Gaston, it doesn't matter, praise God, all over this world, hallelujah, the Spirit of the living God is being poured out. I'm expecting a mighty revival. People are going to wake up and come out of their closets, praise God, hallelujah. Somebody say glory. Glory, glory, glory. So, Lord, we thank you and we lift you up and we exalt you as we go forth, Lord, to minister your word in this area. Let it go forth all over this place. Let it heal, deliver, but most of all, let it save. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody say amen. Woo! Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Make some noise in this place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. When the enemy go to shaking and moving, you ought to get upset. I said, when the enemy has a whole lot of liberty around you or have liberty to bring death, you ought to be upset. Somebody said, praise God. Ain't nobody, if you want to get upset with somebody, praise God, not people, it's the enemy. Put him under your feet. In the name of Jesus. And you put him in under your feet with the praises of God. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Hallelujah. So when you feel down, when you feel shaken, when you feel distracted, I want you to praise God. But most of all, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, praise God. Hallelujah. It says over in the 14th chapter of St. John, you believe in God. He said, believe in Jesus. Hallelujah. Trust in him as your Savior. Believe on him, praise God. Hallelujah. Who died, hallelujah, went to hell, paid the price, rose from the dead, and sitteth at the right hand of the Father right now. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Hallelujah. There's no other name mentioned among men whereby we might be saved except the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Glory. Glory. I hear him saying the 14th chapter of St. John, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there is many mansions. Somebody say glory. I'm telling you today, there is hope. This is not the end of this thing. Darkness has been allowed so you can see the light. But I'm telling you, both darkness and light have already always been here. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Jesus. The word of God says over in Genesis, let there be light. From that time on, praise God, light has been spreading all over this world, praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. And the light that God is talking about there is the knowledge of God. Did you hear me? The knowledge of God and what he is doing and what his purpose is light. Walk in the light. Live in the light. Live purposefully in the light. But the light is the knowledge of God. Hallelujah. And you cannot know God unless the Spirit of God drew you. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
If you've been born again today, you ought to raise your hands. You ought to blow your horn. If you know him, he said, no man cometh unto me unless the Spirit draw him. It's not by accident, praise God. Not by might nor power, but by his Spirit. God is doing everything. Jesus died so we can receive the Spirit of the living God. Somebody say hallelujah. Debts have been paid. Sin has been paid for. So that we can receive the Spirit of the living God. So in this time, when the enemy is just moving, because he know he doesn't have but a short time, and that we're in the last days. I want you to know, praise God, if I had a team and we was in the last moments, in the last minutes, I would put in my best. You ought to look at your neighbor and say, you must be God's best. You must be God's best. Because God's got you here right now. You must be on the A-team. Hallelujah, praise God. But we just got a few moments left. We just got a few days left, praise God. We just got a few years left. We just got a short time, amen, to accomplish what he has for us to accomplish. And that is that this gospel be preached unto the ends of the world, unto every creature. Somebody say glory. So we've got to be busy about our Father's business. Somebody say amen in the house.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So I need us to know who we are, who we are, who we are, and what we should be doing, praise God. What is God calling you to do? He's calling you to represent him. Somebody, you say the word ambassador.
Ambassador.
We are to be ambassadors of Yeshua. We are to be ambassadors of Christ. Hallelujah. We are to be ambassadors of God's grace and his mercy. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
So we cannot be distracted in these moments. The enemy will try to touch things, but he can't touch eternal things. He can touch temporal things. So don't get your mind locked up on the temple. Your car, your house, your this, your that. Somebody say praise God. God is concerned, he's concerned with souls. Eternal souls. Souls are going to be, they're going to live somewhere for eternity. And God has purposed that all souls that come from him, he wants all of them saved. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
You can't discriminate and say who should be saved or who shouldn't be saved. Your mind, praise God, is to bring forth the forgiveness that God has already announced is there. There is forgiveness in the atmosphere. There has been forgiveness that has been released. The sin debt has been paid for, past, present, and future. You've got to let people know. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
We are ambassadors of Christ. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're to represent the kingdom. We're to represent what? The kingdom and God's way. God's way of doing things. God's way of doing things is forgiveness. God's way of doing things is humility, praise God. God's way of doing things is love. Somebody say praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. God's way of doing things, praise God, has to be represented in our walk, our talk, and our thought. Do not be distracted right now. Hallelujah. When people are around you, praise God, amen. I'm sure, praise God, amen, people are concerned about some of the issues that have happened around in our community in the last few days, praise God. And our hearts go out to the Moore family and to the Seals family, praise God. Amen. But I want you to know, praise God, we're busy about our Father's business, and we are letting people know about Jesus and giving them the opportunity to receive him, praise God. Even a mortal death cannot overcome the gospel of Jesus Christ. This Zoe life, he said, if you believe in him, you shall live, what? Forever. Absent from the body, present with the Lord. Somebody say glory in the house.
Glory!
Hallelujah. Some of you are losing loved ones. And even as we speak, we're reading about different ones that are passing, that are going on, praise God. Amen. But if they know the Lord, they have victory. If they know the Lord, they have victory. Our job is to let all men know. From your family to your community, your neighbors, let all men know about the saving grace that is in Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He is our Savior, praise God. Somebody say glory in the house. Amen. In the name of the, we're his ambassadors. We're ambassadors of the kingdom. We do not represent ourselves. We represent the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We do not represent ourselves. We represent the kingdom of God, his way of doing things. We do not represent ourselves, so don't get caught up in yourself. He said, lay your cares on me, I care for you. Lay your cares on me. Don't let the enemy touch, don't let him know he can touch things around you and you'll shake. Don't shake with the storm. It's been storming ever since he said, let there be light. There's been a storm. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't worry, but don't look as if the storm has just come up now. It hasn't just started now. It's been happening all the time. It's just his grace and mercy has kept it hid from us, praise God. But in the last days, you got to know what you're dealing with. Even as the cover's being taken off this great United States that we are in, and you are seeing the things, praise God, the essence of the heart. You see the racism. You see the lying and the cheating, and you see all of these things. It's all over the world. It's wherever men are. It's wherever mankind is. It's wherever the devil is roaming to and fro, praise God. Hallelujah. It's just been hid. But now as it's uncovered, don't act as if it's something that just appeared. It did not just appear. It always has been. Let not your heart be troubled about your finances. Let not your heart be troubled, even about your own health. I'm telling you, he's a healer and he's a provider, praise God. He's a deliverer. He will set you free. Somebody say glory, praise God. His power and life goes beyond the grave. It goes beyond death, praise God. Oh, death, where's thy sting, praise God? Grave, where's your victory? Where is the victory? If God, hallelujah, praise God, amen, has given us what? Eternal life. Somebody say eternal life. Eternal. We have eternal life with him, praise God, amen. So focus on the hope of the things that are to come. Focus on the eternal life of God. Somebody say praise God. Our purpose then as ambassadors is to edify the body of Christ as to our mission and bring the body of Christ here in to build up the body of Christ here on the earth. That's our purpose. Our purpose, praise God, is for the body of Christ to grow up and not be distracted, not be moved, but we continue to preach the gospel in season, out of season. When it looks good, when it don't look bad. I'm telling you, the kingdom of God is at hand, and we need to be entering in. We need to be calling people to the kingdom. We need to allow them to see the superiority of the kingdom of God over the things of the earth, but they can't see it if you're troubled by temporal, material things. Let not your heart be what? Trouble. He ain't given us a spirit of fear, but one of love and power and a sound mind. We all are going to first face the first death. We've already got it licked if we know our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's been appointed to us, praise God. Amen. But in that season, when he come, all he can do is usher us into the presence of the Lord. Absent from the body, present with the Lord. That's all he can do. The one you need to be concerned with is the second death. Hallelujah. Where we are separated from our God, praise God, at the great white throne judgment. We don't want to be there. We want to be, hallelujah, at the judgment seat of Christ. And we don't want to be ashamed at the judgment seat of Christ. I don't want my works burned up, Brother Young, praise God. I want my works to have the right motive behind them. Hey, works are important to a saint because we're laying up our timber. We're making our investment in a place that you haven't seen, but you know it's there. Ah, somebody say glory. Somebody say hallelujah. I heard a street saved with gold. I heard them gates made of pearl. Somebody said, glory. I heard them say there, no more tears there. No more concerns there. No more worry there. Somebody said, hallelujah. I don't even have to worry about the sun because Jesus, hallelujah, he is the sun of that time. He is the light of that place, and it will never go out. It will never get dark. Somebody said, glory. I'm investing. Somebody say, I'm investing. I'm investing. I'm investing. I'm making an exchange. Anybody ever made an exchange? If I go over to Europe, I probably got to make an exchange of the American currency into the currency they use over in Europe. I know they're trying to come up with a one world currency right now, but until they do, you got to make an exchange for that currency where you're going. Somebody say, hallelujah. Baby, you better be making an exchange. You better be making an exchange. You better exchange the things in temporal, the things that are of this world. Exchange your money. Exchange your time. Exchange your talent. Exchange it for the faith that pleases God. He says, impossible to please him without faith. Faith pleases God when I can believe in something I can't see. I haven't walked on it yet, but I know it's some streets of gold. I haven't opened the door yet, but I know it's a pearly gate. Somebody say, hallelujah. Bless his name, praise God. I know, praise God, that absent from the body, the moment I quit breathing here, I'm going to wake up and I'm going to be in his presence. Oh, in his presence. In the presence of the living God. In the blessed presence of the one who died for me. The one who went to the cross for me. The one who paid for my sins. Somebody say, glory. I can look into my future. I got a future and I got a hope. Somebody say, hallelujah. I got a what? I got a future. I got a future past this. I got a future past this situation. I got a future past my sins. I got a future past my disappointments. I got a future past my faith, my fears. Somebody say, praise God. I have a future. And so I'm going to put my hope in nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness, because his righteousness can't be touched. But the work that he did on the cross, which was paying for my sins, is sealed. Somebody say, hallelujah. Oh yeah, I've been sealed with the Holy Ghost. Somebody say, glory. A seal lets you know something has been purchased, something has been bought, something belongs to something else. I got a seal on my life. Somebody say, glory. And the Holy Ghost is that seal. How do you know when you've been saved? The Spirit of the living God lives on the inside of you, pricking in your Zoe life. And past this disappointment, past your fears, past this trouble, past Trump, past Biden, past all of that, I got a hope. I don't care who sits in the White House. I know who sits on the throne. Somebody say, glory. Yeah, he wants us to be our ambassador. If you live with that hope, you won't allow what the report of the enemy is. You will not allow it to shake you. Hallelujah. You get news all the time, and they want to give you bad news. Everybody's reporting on how many have died from the virus. I don't hear no reports about how many made it through it, about how many overcame it. I don't hear no report about who got healed or who got delivered or who overcome. I need the report of the Lord. You have believed our report. Our report is the report of the Lord. Hallelujah. He sits on high. Somebody say, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he ministers us. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear. Somebody say, hallelujah. I will fear. I will fear no evil. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, because greater, what, is he that is in me than he that is in the world. So we walk through the life as ambassadors of hope. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You might not have no money in the bank, but you got hope. You might not get the one you want in the White House, but you got hope. You might not have a house you want, but you got hope. You might not have a car you want, but you got hope. Children might not be acting like you think they'll act, but you got hope. Husband might have left you. Wife might have left you, but God ain't left you. Somebody say, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hear the word of the Lord. He said he's nigh thee, even in thy mouth. This word of faith which I preach, it is there. All you got to do is call on the name that represents all hope. Call on the name that represents all life. Call on the name that represents all power. I'm talking about resurrection power, past the grave. Power that raises from the grave, defeats death. What is that name? That name is Jesus. 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 They say, well, Brother Simmons, are you mad? Yeah, I'm mad at the devil. He ain't got no business coming that close, making a steal that close. Praise God. Hallelujah. Wake yourself up. Shake yourself. Begin to go to war. Somebody say hallelujah. Begin to go to war. You say, well, what is my war? He said, the battle's not yours. It belongs to him. My job is to praise him. My job is to declare his goodness. My job is to declare his might and his power and his payment for my sin. My job is to declare his hope. My hope is in him. Somebody say hallelujah. When I declare that, light comes. Somebody say hallelujah. Light comes out of your spirit and defeats darkness. Life comes out of your spirit and pushes death back. Somebody say hallelujah. Right, life brings victory out of the grave. This life brings victory out of the failed doctor's report. When the doctor says there's nothing else I can do, then you tell him thank you, because I know who can do more than you can do. I'm going to call on that name. Somebody said Jesus. Somebody said Jesus. Somebody said Jesus. Somebody said Jesus. Hallelujah. Ain't nobody mad but the devil. Somebody said thank you now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So our purpose is for the body of Christ to grow up, so we can work on the orchestration of the Holy Ghost as he dispatches us into dark, dismal, hopeless areas, that we would bring the light of his hope into those areas. Somebody say glory. And it's got to be coordinated. Jesus is the head. He gives the order. Somebody say glory. And whatever he says, do. I heard Mary say, do whatever he tells you to do. And I heard Jesus say, I only do what the Father told me to do. We need to come back from all this stuff, our good intentions and our good ideas. And we need to get on our knees and listen for God's direction as the Holy Ghost begins to place us into the place where we should be, in the power that we should be in, as ambassadors of Christ, telling people about a land that they haven't seen, about a kingdom that is coming and a king that's gonna rule it. I'm telling you about somebody, praise God, hallelujah, that can be fair to everybody, that can be a blessing to everybody. You know, when some people get blessed, some people, if you're blessed over here in this country, in this temporal situation we're in, when somebody gets blessed, somebody else gets left out. But I'm talking about a kingdom where ain't nobody left out. Oh, glory. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I heard somebody sing a song, say, I know there's a blessing with my name on it. You ought to say your name right now, because there's some things there that's got your name on it. Hallelujah. There's some healing, got your name on it. There's some deliverance, got your name on it. There's some peace, got your name on it. Hallelujah. There's some strength, got your name on it. Anybody out there needs strength today? Anybody need encouragement today? You are an ambassador of Christ. He has equipped you to walk in the victory. He said that you're more than a conqueror through him that has loved you. Somebody say hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Hallelujah. God's purpose will always prevail. God's purpose will what? Always prevail. Somebody say hallelujah. Daniel 2:37, Romans 11:25 through 36. God's purpose, his will is going to be done. Somebody say glory. Hallelujah. So if you want to walk in the light, walk in the purpose of God. Thank you, Jesus. If you want to walk in the light, walk in the purpose and the will of God. Jesus walked as a son, and that's how we are to walk. We are to be the ones now that are led by the Spirit of God. So God, from his throne, can order our steps. I heard him say the steps of a good man are ordered of God. 2 Corinthians 5:20 said, now then we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. That's my word for you today. Be reconciled to God. He has paid the price for our sins. He has redeemed us. The Holy Spirit has revealed himself to you. And now you have confessed Christ. Now you ought to want everybody around you coming to that kingdom, available to that knowledge, walking in the light. What is the light? The light is the purpose of God. Only the Holy Spirit can reveal that purpose to you. That light is the purpose that God has called you forth to do. Somebody say amen. Only the Holy Spirit can let you know that. That spirit that lives on the inside of you. Pay more attention to the Spirit of God living in you. The Word of God that he sends you. The people of God that are around you than to the world. Somebody say amen. If the Word of God said, if you're led by the Spirit of God, ye are the what? Sons of God. God's glory is sons. God's glory is when a human being filled with the Spirit of God walks at the direction of the Holy Spirit. That is the glory of God. Every time you see a man or a woman obey God, you're going to see life. The result of that is life. That life is coming out of from the throne room to his spirit, from his spirit into this temple, and it will change things. It is the Zoe life of God that is able to appear and break through all the evil and all the darkness, praise God. Just because these lights come on, these temple lights that we shine at night and on these cars, it does not mean that we are in light. This world is a fallen world. It has fallen into darkness. Why are you surprised at the actions of our leaders and our government? How are you surprised at the storming of the Capitol? Why are you surprised at the death and the viruses and the things that are going on? That's been going on. That's been happening, praise God. But the light is here, and it is here to be had. The kingdom of God is at hand. You can enter that kingdom, and you can live according to that joy. Even in this present darkness, you can be a light. You are ambassadors of Christ. So I commission you. Somebody say hallelujah. I commission you, praise God, as ambassadors of Christ. Let not your heart be troubled. When you read the word, it tells you of these last days and the things that are going to be happening, praise God. But Jesus said in Matthew 24, I believe, he said, the end is not here yet. It's not the end. This is not the end just because they're storming this and storming that. We still got time. What do we have time to do, Brother Simmons? Lead souls to the kingdom. Lead souls to the kingdom. Start in your house. Extend it to your community. Go out into the ends of the world, wherever the Lord sends you, on your workplace, in the hedges, highways, and byways. Tell people about the goodness of our God. And you will see the result, praise God. Many souls will be added to the kingdom of God on your account. Somebody say hallelujah. 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 Father, we thank you. We thank you for your love and your kindness and your blessing. We thank you for calling us as ambassadors. We thank you for sending us into the darkness. And even in the midst of the darkness, you have given us a light on the inside of us that will not go out. So I say like Jeremiah, it's like fire shut up in my bones. Lord, we can't help but preach this gospel, this good news, this life-giving water, this bread of life, this mighty sword of the Spirit into this present darkness and cut it away so men, women, boys, and girls can be free from their chains, from their bondages in the name of Jesus. We come against the spirit of hopelessness and fear and intimidation. I come against a weary spirit. The word of God says, weary not in well doing, for in due season ye shall reap a harvest. We got a due season coming. We got a time coming where we're going to reap this harvest. Until that time, let us work while it is day, because there's a nighttime coming where no man can work. People of God, be blessed. Know how much God loves you. Know that He is for you. If there's anything, praise God, that we can do for you, let us know here at 924 East Broad. In Jesus' name. Somebody say, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.